Ladies and gentlemen, 2006 Kennedy Center honoree, Smokey Robinson.
It's a story that a lot of guys know. You're out there hanging in your early teens, cool as cool can be, doing whatever it is with your buddies. And there's this young girl, the kid's sister, tomboy type, hanging around, trying to get in on things, and you just can't get rid of her. What I didn't realize was that that early sweet persistence will result in a friendship that has lasted our lifetime. When I first got going with the Miracles, she would come sometimes, sit around while we were rehearsing, and you could just tell she would be great. She had this voice, and I knew if she ever got a real shot, there would be no stopping her. I waited till they graduated from high school, and I wrote a song for them called Your Heart Belongs to Me. They did a great job, but the song did nothing. And then we brought in Holland Dozier Holland to write for them, and it was magic. Baby, baby, where did our love go? Ooh, don't you want me? I don't know why I didn't think to write that. We had a school in Motown called Artist Development, who taught them charm and etiquette and how to be real Motown stars. Diana was always the best in those classes. She really wanted to be Diana Ross. Lady Supreme, I love you, Diana Ross. Diana was all eyes, all dreams, all determination. At 15, she sang doo-wop with her friends, the Primettes, and imagined the places music could take them. Her dreams began to come true on West Grand Boulevard, where Motown was changing the sound of young America. With their first hit, they flew out of the nest and landed on top of the charts and stayed there. They were the most successful female group in the country. 12 number one hits, 7 gold records. At a time when black and white in America were just beginning to come together, these young, beautiful black women filled America's stages and TV screens. As big as the Beatles, but with a better wardrobe, they had proved a pop trio could conquer the world. Could Diana? Times declared her the perfect pop queen. But she knew she owed a debt to the women of song who had tried to walk the path of stardom before her. She poured her soul into the drug-ridden life of the legendary Billie Holiday.
If I should take a notion to jump into the ocean, if I do, if I go to
a heartbreaking performance.
Monday,
it won her an Oscar nomination.
Touch me in the morning.
She would become the brightest star in the entertainment sky.
Suddenly my world from the movies changed its face, but to a Tony Award on Broadway.
Know where I'm going. And
she teamed up with Lionel Richie to make the most popular love ballad in pop music. A mentor to young talent, she's an inspiration for the next generation with dreams of their own.
I see trees of green, red roses too.
Pioneer in silks and sequins, she flies on the wings of song.
It's a wonderful world.
The Kennedy Center Honors will return with a musical tribute to Diana Ross.